exactly what is autophagy and why it is so important to our health. Autophagy is a Greek-derived term that means self, auto, eating, phagy, autophagy. It's actually our body way of clearing out old cells, damaged cells, and proteins to make room for new, healthy ones. In other words, autophagy is an ultimate natural body cleanse. So very quickly, if this is your first time on my channel, my name is Maria and welcome. I am an esthetician, an instructor, an examiner for many years. I have an online aesthetics training program for individuals that want to become certified estheticians or for personal knowledge. Give me comments below. Love to connect with you. If you have not subscribed yet, please consider it. Give me likes. That will help my channel immensely. And click the notification bell so you will not miss any of my educational tutorials. So let's get started. As you age, and as a normal response to just going through life, proteins and organelles in the cell, in your body, get damaged or die. During autophagy, the body marks damaged parts of cells, unused proteins, and other junk in the body for removal and clears them out. This is a form of cellular cleansing and really a true meaning of detox. Autophagy also helps deliver nutrients to cells that needs them. So basically, autophagy can dictate not only how well we live, but perhaps how long we live. It is a key physiological mechanism that has been conserved throughout evolution for distinct purpose of allowing human species to strive. But when the autophagic mechanism are overwhelmed or dysfunctional, cells are unable to perform optimally, and disease can occur, as well as more rapid aging, and that is something that we don't want. Autophagy is absolutely essential for healthy, functioning cells, and if it's never kicked on, it is in its full potential, you can get sick. One of the most notable ways these dead proteins accumulate is seen in individuals with Alzheimer's disease. Because these are never cleared out from the body, dead protein travel to the brain and get stuck there, causing characteristic plaques associated with this disease. Healthy benefits of autophagy. I know it works because I personally do it daily. Having a clean body and properly functioning cellular pathways is the foundation of health. That's why autophagy has such a far-reaching major benefits, and I want to list just a few of them for you. So to stimulate you that you might want to say, you know what, I need to start. So the first one that I want to bring up is healthy aging. We are all going to get old and older. But have you noticed some people seem to age faster than others in terms of appearance, energy, and overall health? That's because cellular aging occurs as a result of accumulation of damaged proteins and organelles that interferes with normal body function and repair. And some people have more of these damaged protein and do less to clear them out than others. Regular stimulating of autophagy can help keep cells healthy and repair pathways to help the body age gracefully and healthily. So number two, and that's the one that I like, is weight management. When it comes to weight loss, intermittent fasting, a tactic that almost always works when everything else have failed. And I know all about it. That's because obesity and related metabolic disorders like insulin resistance and diabetes are related to lack of autophagy. On the other hand, stimulating autophagy may help clear damaged proteins to reduce weight and weight-related complications. Number three, it lowers inflammation. Autophagy helps shut off inflammation by controlling the action of several types of inflammatory cells, including macrophages and lymphocytes and other ones. Because autophagy is a powerful anti-inflammatory, stimulating autophagy may help the severity of several inflammation-related conditions like Crohn's disease, cystic fibrosis, and chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, which a lot of people know it as COPD. Autophagy also helps balance insulin levels, which decreases inflammation and has positive effect on your gut health. Number four, better brain health and the fogginess and the memory, all that. It is notable that most neurodegenerative disorders such as Alzheimer's disease and Parkinson's disease are associated with accumulation of misfolded proteins, so impaired autophagy may contribute to these diseases. However, they do not understand how this completely works. Just do it. The process may also provide protection against other neurodegenerative diseases such as Huntington's disease and the amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, which most people know as ALS, as cited by the review in the Journal of Neurobiology of Aging. The same research further suggests that this is because of autophagy helps clear out damaged proteins that can accumulate in the brain, which ultimately contributes to aging and brain-related diseases. Number five, reduce risk of heart disease. Defects in autophagy have been connected to heart disease, heart attack, and also the hardening of our arteries, arteriosclerosis. Stimulating autophagy may help clear out damaged heart cells, keeping your heart healthy and protecting against arteriosclerosis. Number six, better blood sugar control. Autophagy is essential for the proper functioning of your beta cells, the cells in your pancreas that produces the insulin. Some research, including a study in the Journal of Cellular and Molecular Medicine, that looked at both human and rat insulin cells, the INS1, connects the development of type 2 diabetes to hamper autophagy. On the other hand, stimulating autophagy may keep beta cells healthy and helps improve insulin sensitivity and insulin signaling. However, always, always include your doctor on whatever you decide to do before you start. Number seven, lower the risk of cancer. Of course, if you clean things out, you will lower that risk. The role of autophagy in cancer is a little bit controversial. If in the early stages of cancer, autophagy can prevent tumor growth and prevent cancer from spreading. Yes. However, if tumors are in the late stage, autophagy may actually contribute to their growth. In other words, autophagy may help stop cancer before it starts. But if you have cancer, stick to your doctor's recommendations for treatment. Would you want to try to stimulate autophagy? Would you? I would. All the benefits that you have with it is amazing. Now, how can you induce autophagy? Let me put you down. You want to go down? Okay, you go for your little nap. Since autophagy is really the foundation of keeping your body healthy, clean, and free from cell pollution, it's important to activate it regularly. Fortunately, most of the things that turn this powerful cellular cleansing process are actually really simple to incorporate. And some of the things that induce autophagy and can also improve your lifespan are the right diet, regular exercising, reduce your stress level, quality of sleep, and taking cold showers, going outside, going to nature, social connection, and releasing any kind of trauma in your life. But many experts seem to agree that the single most effective way to kick autophagy into high gear is through intermittent fasting. Intermittent fasting for autophagy basically is nutrient deprivation or ongoing without eating. It is a primary trigger for autophagy. Now, that might sound like something that you do not want to do, and I felt the same way, but that's exactly what intermittent fasting is, and it's a physiological state that your body actually strives on. When I started to do intermittent fasting, I said, oh my goodness, I don't want to do that. I love food. I can't stay without food. But you can start slowly and increase the amount of your fasting. And I do have two tutorials, so please do look at them. The difference of the types of intermittent fasting and how long and what are the benefits of the intermittent fasting. That's why intermittent fasting is a great tool. It alternates periods of eating, which is feasting, with periods of fasting, or nutrient deprivation. This balance ensures that damaged cells get cleared out, but healthy cells remain intact. Now, some foods that promote autophagy. I recommend starting with plant-based rich diets, especially with plants that are rich in phytochemicals that haven't been stripped out through the food processing or modern GMO agricultural practices. Some of the phytochemical rich products or plants are like broccoli, cabbage, kale, dark leafy greens, Swiss chard, dandelion greens, arugula, tomatoes, and carrots, sweet potatoes, squash, all the berries, apples, onion, garlic. Some antioxidant rich foods and drinks that deserve a regular spot on your plate are walnuts, pecans, bilberry, blueberry, strawberry, Golgi berries, beets, artichokes, beans, dark chocolate, yes, coffee, espresso, pomegranate fruit, and also pomegranate juice. It's also a good idea, yes, to avoid sugars, processed oils and processed foods, fast foods. Now, if you have it once in a while, it's not going to kill you. But if that is part of your daily diet, you might want to look at different ways of eating. Autophagy has some pretty impressive benefits, but there's no magical internal switch that you can turn on and off. If you really want to reap the benefits of autophagy, you have to make inducers like intermittent fasting a regular part of your life. Now, for healthy people, doing so is virtually a reward and no risk. However, if you have diabetes, hyperthyroidism, or adrenal gland dysfunction, please, you have to talk to your doctor first. So, now that I explained the difference and the benefits of intermittent fasting, why do you want to do intermittent fasting? Is it for health reasons? Is it because you want to lose some weight? Or that you want to slow down the aging process or plaque in your brain? Yes. Please write down comments below and do look at my other tutorials on intermittent fasting. My main focus is that I do not want to get Alzheimer's or fogginess in my head or age quicker than what I want to age. We all going to age, but to slow down the process, that is my main key. Remember to treat yourself with love and respect. Until the next time, take care.